Well, the story of Nirvana's time in Madison, shortly before the band made it big, has never been documented in full detail until now.
For Madison Magazine's July issue, freelance writer Kurt Stream tells the story of Madison's pivotal role in the band's success. The managing editor of Madison Magazine, Andrea Behrling, joins us now. Welcome back. It's been, what, 15 months since you've been in person?
Over a year. This is cool.
Good to see you.
Good to see you guys.
This is the magazine that's going out to subscribers today.
Yes. Yep. But then this one is what will be on newsstands June 30th, and I'm super excited. This is the first time anyone's seeing this.
Yeah, that's the
This story's in here, too, as
it
well.
It is. There's Kurt Cobain on the cover. So tell us how this story came about. What is the story about Nirvana in Madison? I've never heard it before.
It's great, and we got connected with Kurt Stream, who you guys are going to talk to in a couple weeks here. He's a freelance writer that got connected to our creative director, and has this story that he started collecting interviews about when Nirvana came to Madison right before they, like a year before they released their Nevermind album.
It's like 1990?
Yeah, around there in the 90s, and they were a little no-name band, played for less than 30 people at OK's Corral.
For $100 or something.
Yeah, and it's, you know, and this story has never been told before in as much detail as Kurt Stream has done, and he actually got connected with a photographer that took these with a disposable camera.
Really?
Still had the negatives for 30 years later, and our creative director, Tim Burton, went and picked them up and developed them, and we're so excited.
Well, they weren't even developed yet?
I think they might have been developed before, but he got them developed himself.
So from there, why were they here? I mean, they were performing, but then they started recording here.
They did, yeah. So they got connected with Butch Vig while they were in
garbage fame.
Yes, and Smart Studios, and they went to Smart Studios. They recorded songs, and Kurt's going to be able to give you the better story here, but they recorded songs at Smart Studios that would end up becoming the songs on Nevermind that Butch Vig also produced and recorded.
Wow, and he got some never-before-seen pictures for this article, and some really interesting keepsakes. Like, I understand they sent the check to Kurt Cobain's house in Seattle.
Yes. Yep. It's the original invoice.
The invoice. That's the word I'm looking for.
Sent to Kurt Cobain's address, and Kurt Stream did an amazing job of like finding all of this stuff. He really did a ton of work. These are the original notes from their session at Smart Studios, and that's Butch Vig there. So it's and just to have it in print, and Tim Burton just did an amazing job.
And this will be on newsstands in a couple weeks.
June 30th.
Subscribers are getting this one probably tomorrow or the next day.
Yep, and they get to read it first.
All right, Andy, thanks for being with us.
Yeah,
pretty exciting
good to
stuff.
See you. Good to see you guys.